the new home of the Braves, MLB Network welcomes you to Truist Park. A good matchup here for you tonight between the New York Yankees and the Atlanta Braves.
And now, your 2021
It's Interleague Baseball,
Atlanta
next on MLB Network.
Braves.
Oscar Yinawa, the right-handed native of the Dominican Republic, will be the starter. Dan, any thoughts?
Well, one thing to look out for him, Matt, is if he can avoid the big inning. It's not that big of a deal to give up a run here or there, but sometimes he can be prone to giving up three or four in an inning, and that kind of derails the whole start when that happens. Limit the damage, and he'll be just fine.
So here's the veteran, Brett Gardner, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Ball and two strikes now. Temperature reading an even 80 degrees at first pitch tonight. Here comes the 1-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Here now the 2-2. Fouled away. And a good pitch there as this is swung on and missed for the first out of the ball game.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location. So a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
To the plate now, DJ LeMahieu. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. And we're just underway from Truist Park. This one's down to third. On to Freeman at first, and there are two away now.
That is third.
With that, here's a look at the Yankees starting lineup. Dan Plesac, who are you focused on?
Yeah, I'm keeping an eye on DJ LeMahieu. This guy put together one of those ridiculous seasons last year. His numbers were off the chart, and he hit everything. Breaking balls, changeups, splits. The league couldn't figure him out, and he went berserk on the whole year. Consistent from April till October. Amazing season.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Line drive snagged on a short hop. Throw in time and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. And now the Braves will step up for their first opportunity to score. Jordan Montgomery gets the ball for the Yankees in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Really like this guy. He reminds me a lot of Andy Pettit, left-hander from the University of South Carolina. Not an overpowering fastball, kind of like Andy Pettit. Low to mid-90s fastball, good curveball. His secondary pitches he needs to improve on a little bit, but this guy has a bright future. Quality arm from the left side.
Now to the plate, Ozzie Albies. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1. Is taken for ball two.
Two balls, one strike.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And he fouls this one off.
Put that in a memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
The 2-2 one more time. Fly ball out toward left center field. Gardner is there. And that's the first out of the inning.
batting second. The right
and
fielder.
Time now to take a look at how these Braves are lined up in this one.
So
thoughts,
there.
Stan, who stands out?
Well, Matt, I'm excited to get a chance to see that left-handed hitter, Freddie Freeman. He won the National League Hank Aaron Award last year. That goes to the best offensive player in the league, hands down. That's why the award is there, and he was so deserving. He's a heck of a hitter.
Bases are empty, one man out. Fastball called strike, 1-2. Grounded weakly toward third. Fielded cleanly. Throw gets him, two down.
Batting third.
Well executed two-seamer on the outside corner
Freddy.
That time. And that's what you'll
Freeman.
Get a lot of with that pitch. He rolled right over it.
Standing in now, Freddie Freeman. Started to go around there. Looked like he held up in time. No, strike two, says the third base umpire. The 1-2 is looked at for ball number two.
Yeah, and if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to go out there and throw that same pitch till he proves he can lay off of it.
Shoots this one over to first. And Boyd will take this one over to the bag, and that ends the inning. An inning in the books tonight, still scoreless here on MLB Network. All set for the start of the inning, and up to bat next, the left-handed light tower power of Joey Gallo. Sliced hard down the left field line, and he's going to kick off the second with extra bases. And he's got himself a leadoff double to begin the second.
When it left his bat, I thought it might squirt foul, but it hugged the line and found its way into the corner. Thought it might be a little bit closer play at second, but he cruised in there with relative ease.
Stepping in now, Gary Sanchez. And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
Everything this guy throws moves. That two-seamer has a mind of its own.
2-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
Had the weight back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Fouled off. Another 2-2 offering. Gallo leads off second with nobody out. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
Well, I think that pitch is the result of a lot of foul balls. He might have tried to do a little bit too much with it, trying to get him to swing through it, but it just ended up taking off on him.
And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been sent a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
In now, Luke Voit. Now Voit with a high fly ball out to deep left field. Left fielder looking up. To the track, to the wall, and this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left, and this is now a 2-0 lead for the Yankees.
That's what I love about baseball. The pitch before, he looked absolutely foolish, but he gathered himself, stayed with the plan, and the next pitch he goes yard. Every pitch is another chance.
So now to the plate, Rougned Odor pops this one up, and no one will get this one. Here comes the 1-2. Still only one out in the inning. And another foul ball. And it's fouled away. Here he comes again, 1-2. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
It's never easy to rebound after serving up a two-run shot, but that at bat was a good indication to me that he isn't letting it get to him. He went right after him for the strikeout.
At the plate now, Tyler Wade. Swing and a miss for strike three. Pulled the string on him that time, and the inning is over. Yankees get a couple on the two-run home run. We'll go to the bottom of the second. It's now 2-0 New York. Last half of the second set to go, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Austin Riley.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. Solo shot here to left, and the Braves have struck for a run. It's now a 2-1 game.
Hey, listen, there's an old adage in baseball that solo home runs won't kill you. This is one of the top hitters in that lineup, so a home run, a solo home run right here, it's not the end of the world.
At the plate, Dansby Swanson lays off, 2-2 now.
Playing two balls, two strikes.
Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Fouled away. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. And he fouls this one off. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Another full count pitch home. Neither guy giving in here, and they'll do it again. Fouled off. He'll try it again, 3-2. And he finally puts him away here as he strikes him out after an 11-pitch at-bat.
That strikeout was a real good example of a pitcher continuing to make a guy chase out of the zone. When you recognize a hitter is in protect mode, you don't have to come inside the strike zone. You can just expand further and further until he literally can't touch it.
Into the box, Adam Duvall. No contact there, and it's one and two. Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out.
This tells me a lot about this guy. He's done a real nice job bouncing back from that home run to strike out the next two guys. Sometimes you're going to get taken deep, but it's all about how you respond that really matters.
To the plate now, Travis d'Arnaud. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time.
Name of the game out on the mound is to disrupt timing of the hitters in the box. He certainly got this guy on the defensive.
Travis d'Arnaud with an even 2-2 count now.
Hey, I got to commend him a little bit. Lead off homer, and now he's one pitch away from getting out of this inning without any further damage.
And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get in the chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
So a runner at first with two away, and in steps a former World Series hero, the outfielder Jock Peterson. Now the 2-1. Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. D'Arnaud, the runner at first with two gone. Jock swings and sends a ball to deep right. And out of here, and I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. Jock Peterson with a two-run blast. And Atlanta's taken a 3-2 lead.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
Stepping in now, Oscar Yinawa. 1-2 now to the Braves pitcher.
One ball, two strikes.
Now a swing and a fly ball. Judge is on his horse and foul. Now another 1-2. Three runs already home here. Hit on the ground out to short. He's right there. Throw on to Voit takes care of him, and the inning is over. So two home runs in the inning lead to three runs on the scoreboard. We'll go now to the top of the third. It's the Braves 3 and the Yankees 2. So now the pitcher for the Yankees, Jordan Montgomery, 9-1-2 due up. The 1-1. Now a ball lined to the left side, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Pitch on the way. And it's fouled away. Here's another 1-2. Half swing here, but it won't matter. It's strike three called anyway, and that's out number one.
You know, I'm not quite sure how that strikeout will be scored, looking or swinging. He tried to check his swing, but I'm pretty sure the home plate umpire was ringing him up regardless.
So now to the plate, Brett Gardner. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Now here's the pitch. 1-2 is an off-speed pitch. No dice. It's 2-2. Third inning. Already a 3-2 ball game. 3-2 to the Yankees center fielder.
3 balls, 2 strikes. Down is full.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Grounded to short. Swanson scoops it up. On to first, and there are two down.
Up next for the Yankees, the second baseman, D.J. LeMahieu.
Bases are empty here with two away, and that'll bring up D.J. LeMahieu. Now the 3-2 pitch. High in the air out to center field. Peterson has a read on it. And that ends the inning. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. Still a 3-2 ball game. Bottom of the third now. And standing in as the switch hitting second baseman, Ozzie Albies. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Here's a bouncing ball headed to LeMahieu at second. And there's one down now.
The batter, the right fielder, Jorge Soler.
In is Jorge Soler, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Here's the 1-1 delivery. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. All even now, 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
One out, nobody on. Ground ball sent back up the middle. LeMahieu's got it. Throw gets him, two down.
The first baseman, number 5, Freddie Freeman.
So next up will be Freddie Freeman. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Now a big fastball, and he's well behind it with the swing. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball. Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose. Two and two the count. Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a two-seamer, and the inning is over. Braves are set down 1-2-3, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already, and he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. And that'll bring up Aaron Judge. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
Well, I have to give credit to him on the mound for not letting that previous pitch get to him. He wanted it, but he didn't get the call. But I love how he didn't let it affect him, and he comes right back with another good pitch and gets the punch out.
In now, Joey Gallo. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three-ball count.
Ready on 3-1. Here's the pitch. Chopper to short. Swanson picks it up. Throw on to first. Two gone.
Up next for the Yankees, the catcher, Gary Sanchez.
Now into the box, Gary Sanchez. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch-outs will stick with you a little longer.
No walks yet. Here's the delivery. Ground ball right into the shift. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. They're down 3-2. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I had a chance to discuss the Braves' offense with their manager, Brian Snicker, during the commercial break. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've been able to push across three runs to this point, but they've also made the opposition work extremely hard. He's thrown a lot of pitches, and they think they're going to have a good opportunity to push across a lot more runs as he tires or as they get into that bullpen.
Thank you, Heidi. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And stepping in, the long ball threat, Austin Riley.
He jumped all over breaking stuff last time up on that homer. So I got to believe in the back of his mind, he knows he's probably getting a fastball in during this sequence.
Off balance throw, but he couldn't get enough on it, so it'll be scored as an infield single.
Hey, that's a heck of an effort by the shortstop right there to leave his feet and try and make that throw to first base. Got to be frustrated a little bit as a pitcher. You executed your spot.
Well, I tell you what, you know, as soon as you throw one like that, D-Row, you see your shortstop get a glove on it, you're thinking, okay, maybe he has a shot to get him, but that's a long throw after that jump throw, and it's solid infield base hit, but very frustrating as a pitcher.
LeMahieu for one, but they won't get two as he beats the relay to first. So that one wasn't quite hit sharply enough to turn two.
Yeah, choppers like that make it really tough. You can't make the ball get to you much faster, so the key is making sure you field it cleanly and at least get one, which they did there.
Here's the 1-1. Outside with the fastball as the count moves to 2-1 now.
That's a great call right there. Fastball away with a guy who's got some jets on first base. Almost like a hybrid pitch out. Great for a catcher if that guy's running. Easy transfer throw to second base.
Throw over to the bag and a dive, but he's back in. The 2-1 home. Runners on the move for second. Now a swing as he foul tips it here, and oh, right off his arm behind the plate. That hurts. Hit in the air down the left field line. Gallo is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Up next for Atlanta, the catcher, Travis d'Arnaud.
Here's the catcher, Travis d'Arnaud. No official at bat for him, but he has scored a run in this one. On its way is pitch number 75. And he just misses inside with the fastball there. Into the corner and slicing foul. Here's the 2-2. Hit softly on the ground to third. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Braves strand one, but they still lead it 3-2. Ready to go in the top of the fifth. And here comes the first baseman, Luke Voit.
He turned around that fastball and drove it out of the park in his previous at bat, so there's got to be a good chance they mix it up right here on him and try and go off speed.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. The pitch. Line shot to first, and there's one away.
The batter, the third baseman, Rougned Odor.
At the plate, Rougned Odor. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. A full count for Odor, 3-2.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
2 runs on 2 hits and no errors for the Yankees so far. And that's low, ball four.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
And that'll bring up Tyler Wade, struck out in his first at bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
And so now the Braves will get both a left-hander and a right-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. Lifted down the line and left. Long run for the left fielder, and they can't run it down.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. 2 back-to-back.
He'll try again, 1-2. Fouled away.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
The next 1-2 pitch. And that misses 2-2.
Well, these guys haven't had too many opportunities yet to test the running game in this one, so they could decide to put a man in motion right here.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Duvall is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are 2 gone now.
the pitcher, number 47, Jordan Montgomery.
Now to the plate, the pitcher, Jordan Montgomery, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7, 8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
I don't know if that was discipline or whether he's just not swinging the bat at all, but hey, at least he's making the pitcher throw a few more pitches.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. The 2-2 one more time is looked at, and the count moves full.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And this is in the air down the left field line and into foul territory. Duvall is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. One left for the Yankees. They trail 3-2. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and in steps a former World Series hero, the outfielder Jock Peterson.
Yeah, not fooled by that breaking ball in his last AB at all. He jumped all over it. That's such a good feeling as a hitter when you know you're picking up the secondary stuff right out of the pitcher's hands.
Swinging a soft liner, and this is taken for the out.
The pitcher, number 19, Pasca Yenowa.
Guillermo Heredia will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 38, Guillermo Heredia.
Popped him up. Wade is under this one. Two gone.
The batter, number one, second baseman, Ozzie Albies.
So up steps Ozzie Albies, 0-for-2 with a fly ball and a ground out on his line to this point. And that's on the outside corner, one and two. Double barreled action in the Yankee bullpen now. A lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Two out, nobody on. And this is lifted high in the air down the line behind third. Wade is there. And that ends the inning. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. We're through five here at the ballpark. The Braves lead it 3-2. Chris Martin takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Now pitching for the Braves, number 55, Chris Martin.
Top half of the sixth about to get started. And standing in is the veteran outfielder, Brett Gardner. The 1-1. Pulled toward right center field. On the move is Peterson. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out.
Now batting, the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. 3-2 is our score here in inning number six. Oh, here's a shot out to right center. Legs churning, he's headed for second. And he'll pull into second with one away. Off the bat, it was pretty clear right away that that hit was going to get him at least two bases.
Yeah, Matt, some people like to crow about homers and powering drives, but you have to like hits like this. A no-doubt double the second it left his bat. Like you said, the only question was whether the outfielders were going to be able to keep him at second, which they did.
Standing in now, Aaron Judge. And he fouls this one off.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Hit back up the middle. Albies picks it up, and there are two away now.
Now batting the left fielder, Joey Gallo.
A.J. Minter comes on now, and this move looks to be all about playing the matchup here.
Yeah, and I don't think there's any doubt about that, Matt. They want the lefty-lefty matchup, and that's usually the right move, but we'll just have to see how this plays out.
Joey Gallo will be his first assignment upon entering, as he'll bat with the runner in scoring position here and two away. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's one and two.
This is why you pay the price of admission right here. Power on power. My money's on the pitcher.
Counts even two and two to Joey Gallo. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. The 2-2. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. A big time strikeout and some raw emotion as he gets out of the jam. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Clay Holmes enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and digging in is the outfielder, Jorge Soler. The 1-1 is laid off for ball two. Holmes utilizes a good curveball as a part of his arsenal, but it's not just your run-of-the-mill breaking ball. It's unique in that he's able to throw it with great velocity, a power curve, if you will. Now the 2-1 pitch. Swing and a screamer, but this one's not going to stay fair. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line,
the
but
baseman,
that wasn't a great pitch to do it on.
Freddie.
It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
Into the box, Freddie Freeman. Two balls and a strike to Freeman. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Now a swing and a miss at the hard sinker, and they're back to even 2-2. Lifted in the air to straightaway center. Gardner's after it. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
Now batting, third baseman, Oscar
Austin Riley will stand in here hoping to duplicate what he did back in the second inning as we flash you back to take another look at his solo home run that helped get this offense rolling. The 2-1 home.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
Full count now, 3-2.
Great job by the pitcher right there, changing eye levels. We all know he's a sinker ball pitcher, but if he could throw some four seamers up in the zone like that, it could work for him.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And this is taken low for ball four, and they'll have themselves a two-out base runner here after all.
The batter number 7, shortstop, Dansby.
So it's a runner at first with two men out. And that brings up the former number 1 overall pick, Dansby Swanson. Riley is off of first with two away. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2. From the stretch.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Now the payoff pitch home. Count still full, 3-2. And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
And I'm pretty sure he thought that was a strike. He's thinking, what do I have to do? Put a bow on it? Walk it down and put it in the catcher's glove by myself? I think it got called a little outside, so he has to put it behind him now.
Next up is Adam Duvall. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number 6. The 3-1 pitch. Boy, look at that thing dart. It's full now, 3-2. Here's the payoff pitch. Swing and a miss, and that's out number 3. A couple of walks, but no damage. On to the back third tonight. Stick around on MLB Network. Seventh inning ready to roll, and that'll bring in the veteran catcher, Gary Sanchez. Here comes the 1-2. Ball.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Good battle. Count remains full. Full count, here it comes. Ball. He can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
Nice job there taking care of the leadoff hitter via the strikeout. I'll tell you, in a one-run game, especially this late, getting that first guy in the inning is so important. It changes the whole complexion of the inning, so that was a big out.
Stepping in now, Luke Voit. Swing and a miss on the cut fastball, 1-2.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin the win if he starts looking for it in there.
And that one misses badly. It's ball two.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
2-2. Here it is.
No. Count is full. 3 balls, 2 strikes.
Skied into straightaway right. Soler is there. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
Now batting, third baseman, Rougned Odor.
Digging in will be Rougned Odor. It was a walk in his last trip. Fouled off. Very tight ball game. 3-2 our score in inning number 7. And it's fouled away. Here he comes again, 1-2. Fastball laid off well below the knees. Into right field, that's a base hit.
Up next for the Yankees, the shortstop.
Luke Jackson will get the ball here as he looks to get the final out in the top of the 7th.
Now pitching for the Braves, number 77, Luke Jackson.
To the plate now, Tyler Wade. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
When a pitcher's close to working through a quick inning, that's when you really need to grind out some at-bats. He's done a good job of that, and that's really big when you're hitting towards the bottom of the order.
Out of the stretch, the 3-2 pitch home. And he missed with it. Ball four, so that means now the potential tying run will move into scoring position at second.
The pitcher, number 35.
Giancarlo Stanton will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 27, Giancarlo Stanton.
Big spot. Two out, possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop.
Well, the Yankees have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to see if they can get it, but now sure would be a good time.
Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
Payoff pitch on its way, and he struck him out. So a masterful job of being thrown into the fire and getting the big strikeout to end the inning. Yanks strand a pair. Still a 3-2 ball game. Number 63 will take the ball now as the new pitcher.
Number 63.
So now into the box is Travis d'Arnaud, grounded out in his last at bat. Here's the 1-1 delivery.
Go.
Grounded down the third baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
In now, Jock Peterson. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone. And it looks like the Yankees will have a left-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. Three runs, three hits, and no errors so far for Atlanta. Pulled toward right center field. Gardner comes on now and makes the catch in shallow center for out number two.
Now batting. The pitcher, Luke Jackson.
Aury Adrianza will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 23, Aury Adrianza.
Here's the payoff pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Braves. They're up 3-2. Richard Rodriguez has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 48, Richard Rodriguez.
Ready to begin the eighth, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Brett Gardner. The 3-1. Swing, and he pulls the fastball high in the air toward deep right center. Peterson is to his left as he puts it away in the alley for the first out of the inning.
Now batting, second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
Next, it'll be DJ LeMahieu. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. The 2-1 home. Is a fastball that misses. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
Man, the pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count. And the ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind in a count like that, though.
Time called here as with the potential tying run aboard, they'll make the move to get a little more speed out there. So now to the plate, Aaron Judge. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Quick check on that tying run at first, and the runner back safely. Runners off for second. In there, now the throw. He's in there easily as the throw bounces on the way down.
Now running at second base, number 36.
Davis, the runner at second with one away.
Number
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Runner breaks for third. Pitch inside, the throw. He is not in time. Pretty close, but he got in there safely.
And to me, they just can't let guys get lead like that, especially knowing that the guy behind the plate isn't known for his arm. Here, he swipes third, and they just kind of gave it to him.
Now the 3-2 pitch, fouled away.
The offensive approach here is simple. You know the pitcher's going for the K, so set your sights middle of the plate. And then don't worry about the infielders. They're so close, hard contact is a guaranteed remedy.
And he struck him out. And wouldn't this be something if he could work out of this with that one-run lead still in check?
A lot of indecision there on that check swing, and that's something you see quite a lot on 3-2. When the difference between striking out and drawing a walk can be an inch or two, it's pretty understandable why guys aren't always aggressive with their swings.
And a good eye as he lays off, and the count moves to 2-1 now on the Yankee left fielder.
Boy, that's one of the toughest pitches to lay off, a hard breaking ball at the back foot. Tough take on a terrific pitch.
And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1. The 3-1. 3-1 is a fastball, and he can't connect 3-2.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your A swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power letting it eat.
And, whoa, awfully close, but it's ball four, according to Woody Keller.
Now batting for the catcher.
Tyler Matzek enters the ball game out of the pen, looking for the final out here in the top of inning number 8.
Now pitching for the Braves, number 68.
Greg Allen will be summoned now to be the pinch runner.
Number 22, Greg Allen.
Now it'll be Gary Sanchez. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
Ready with the 2-1. Hit hard on the ground to short. Swanson brings it in. Throw on to first, and the Yankee threat goes by the boards as the inning is over. Yanks strand a pair. They're down 3-2. Greg Allen will stay in the ballgame now and take over in left field.
Now playing left field, number 22,
Andrew Velasquez, is also into the ballgame now as he takes over at second.
Number 71.
And that'll bring in the former top prospect, Ozzie Albies. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch.
Ball. 2-1.
Easy there, big fella. 2-2. Grounded to third, fielded by Adore. And that's the first down.
The right fielder, number 12. Jorge Soler.
One away for the Braves here in inning number 8. And that'll bring up Jorge Soler to hit next. Strike 2 as the fastball is let go. 2-2 to Jorge Soler.
Playing two.
Ball. Won't commit on the slider. Good patience, and it's full 3-2. Freddie Freeman there. He'll hit next. This one, everything we could have hoped for. 3-2 in inning number 8. Fastball too high. Ball 4.
The first baseman, number 5. Freddie.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that brings in Freddie Freeman. Lifted the other way down the left field line. Allen is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Now batting, the third baseman, Austin.
Next to be the cleanup hitter, Austin Riley. It was a walk in his last trip. Soler leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. 2-2. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike 3, and the inning is over. One left for Atlanta, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. Will Smith comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. So kicking off the top of the ninth is Luke Voit, as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. Grounder down the line at third. But this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. And a good hard slider as this one swung on and missed for the first out here in the ninth.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
At the plate now, Rougned Odor, and he strikes him out as well. So two punch outs to begin the outing out of the pen.
Well, you have to feel pretty confident about the way this one's going to end up as a manager. Two hitters, two strikeouts from the closer. There's not a whole lot more he can do to instill confidence that he's going to wrap this thing up without any problem.
Last chance for the Yankees. And he fouls this one off. Now a crowd of 31,000 plus come to their feet. And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. Fouled off.
He's got that certainly timed up now. I'd be shocked if the pitcher goes to the well 3 times in a row with off speed.
Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Hey, this was a pretty tightly played game. Got a little bit of everything in this one. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching, and defense in certain spots. This one was a fun one to watch.
3-2, the finish in tonight's game. Atlanta took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end. Hoskar Yinawa pitches well enough to get the W. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.
the final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious Atlanta Braves, 3 runs on 3 hits, no errors. They left.